Quality care begins with an accurate diagnosis. Visual DX is your fastest second opinion to help guide you in your decision-making process at the point of care. You can build a patient differential, compare diagnoses side by side, search for a diagnosis, access important content such as best tests, management pearls, and therapy. View more than 46,000 images from the most comprehensive medical image database that includes the top resource for dark skin representation. Learn more about medication adverse events. Earn CME. And engage with your patients in the exam room and beyond. Take Visual DX with you wherever you want to go. You can begin building a differential on the Visual DX homepage by entering a symptom, medication, or other finding, such as travel location, or click on the icons to see common chief complaints for each specialty. A 48-year-old woman visits her doctor with a rash of many scattered smooth nodules with an annular configuration and a non-productive cough. On the homepage, let's type in rash. Customize your differential to fit your patient. Change the patient information on the right. Now, click through the workup to add findings. Choose the skin lesion type that best matches your patient. Each lesion type has subcategories with a quick explanation of each. For this patient, we'll add smooth nodule and scattered many in location of skin finding. Then we'll type in annular configuration and cough. The type ahead anticipates your findings. Notice that you can choose different types of cough. You can view the differential at any time by clicking the View This Differential button. And you can edit findings easily. Visual DX breaks down the differential results into six simple categories. Thanks to Visual DX, the patient in this case study was accurately diagnosed with sarcoidosis. We have created a workup for a patient with a rash of many scattered smooth nodules with an annular configuration and a non-productive cough. Let's look at the differential results. The findings we entered are listed at the top of the page. You can always edit findings by clicking the blue button to go back to the workup. Your differential results are categorized into tabs. View all, consider first, consider second, emergencies, infectious, and drug-induced. View all shows every diagnosis included in your results. In most cases, the View all tab is the default tab, unless you enter specific findings. We'll discuss those in a moment. The green 60 tells us there are 60 possible diagnoses in the differential that can match the findings entered. Consider first shows the most common and important diagnoses. Consider second shows uncommon and rare diagnoses. Emergencies groups all diagnoses classified as emergencies, whether they are life-threatening or require immediate attention. Infectious shows infectious diseases. If you enter a travel finding, such as Puerto Rico or Florida, at any point in your workup, the infectious tab will default to the front in your differential results. Drug-induced shows any drug-related diagnoses. If you enter a medication as a chief complaint, the drug-induced tab will appear first in your differential results. Since our patient is a person of color, we have the skin of color toggle turned on. However, we can easily switch to all skin types to see a variety of skin types in our differential view. Within the tabs, you can view the diagnoses in your differential in a number of ways. Since your patient has a rash, Visual DX displays photos for easy comparison. You can switch to the Symptocon view, which displays hallmark symptoms visually, the List view to quickly scan your results, or the Default view, which is a mixture of image types. Change the size of the diagnoses in your differential to show more or less on your screen. Let's look at the differential results for a 60-year-old female pilot with dyspnea, erythroderma, fever, myalgia, and a non-productive cough. Each diagnosis can be represented visually in a number of ways: a photo, medical illustration, radiology image, pathology, and more. We also use Symticons to display hallmark symptoms of diagnoses. The red banner indicates diagnoses that are potentially life-threatening emergencies. The yellow triangle indicates diagnoses that require immediate attention and could leave a patient with permanent organ damage if left untreated. Each diagnosis has a match strength indicator under its name. This tells you how many of your findings match the diagnosis you're considering. In each tab, diagnoses are sorted by best to worst match. You can find out quickly which findings don't match by hovering over the diagnosis. Erythroderma and the pilot occupation are not strong findings for COVID-19, so they are crossed out. Underneath the image are icons that quickly guide you to more information about the diagnosis. The camera icon indicates how many images are available in our database for each diagnosis. There are 97 images connected to COVID-19. A plane icon indicates the diagnosis may be travel-related. A pill icon, as shown under drug-induced hypersensitivity syndrome, indicates the diagnosis can be caused by a medication reaction. Let's review how to edit your findings once you build your differential. For example, your patient's chief complaint is abdominal pain. In the workup, we'll add nausea, vomiting, developed acutely over days to weeks, and appears ill. On the right side of the screen, all your findings are listed. Your chief complaint is highlighted with a green circle, meaning it's a required finding. Required findings will be found in every diagnosis in your differential result. You can add more findings, delete findings by clicking on the X, or make other findings required. Once you click View This Differential, you can easily return to the workup page by hitting the Back button, the Patient Findings link, or the Edit Findings button. VisualDx diagnosis text is written for the point of care, so it can be easily referenced while you are with your patient. Simply type in a diagnosis on the homepage to get started. Content for each diagnosis is original text that has been reviewed by physician experts. Contributors are listed on the top of the page. Jump to the section you want by clicking on the link in the navigation list to the left. We include a synopsis, ICD codes, what to look for, diagnostic pearls, differential diagnosis and pitfalls, best tests, management pearls, therapy, drug reaction data, if applicable, and references. For some diagnoses, we cover the condition in a detailed way for specific age groups. Next to the diagnosis name, click on the drop-down menu to see the page for psoriasis in a child. Some diagnoses affect specific areas of the body in particular ways, and we break those out into separate pages. For instance, psoriasis in hair and scalp pulls up content specific to that body location. We also provide direct links to up-to-date content and PubMed references related to the diagnosis. You can access all the images for a diagnosis here. You can print this page or share a patient handout right at the point of care. If you want to share a diagnosis with a colleague, click the share symbol at the top to copy the link. References for each diagnosis are available at the bottom of the page. VisualDx content is regularly reviewed and updated. Our patient is a 35-year-old female who took naproxen and noticed a smooth plaque appear on her arm. Let's use VisualDx to see if this could be an adverse medication reaction. Since naproxen is our chief complaint, the drug-induced tab appears first. The number in the tab indicates how many diagnoses are categorized by drug-induced. Click on a diagnosis for a quick glance. The medication citations associated with this diagnosis are front and center for you to review. Click through to the full article to review full drug reaction data. You can sort the list by medication name or number of citations by clicking on the headers. In this case, we can see additional information that NSAIDs have 55 total citations associated with urticaria. VisualDx is committed to equity in medicine and improving care for patients with skin of color. Let's review VisualDx features designed to help you with patient care. On the homepage, click on Dermatology Skin of Color to begin building a differential diagnosis. Notice the lesion types display in darker skin tones. Once you enter your findings, your differential diagnosis shows dark skin images first. However, you can easily toggle between skin of color and all skin types. Once you are viewing a diagnosis page, the images are also sorted to display skin of color images first. Again, you can review both skin of color and all skin types using the toggle button. You can also use the Filter Images button to further narrow down the images to specific skin types. Share the images with your patient that resemble your patient's presentation to help build confidence in the diagnosis and improve patient satisfaction. Let's learn how to filter images in the VisualDx image view. In the upper left, notice the toggle button. All skin types will show all skin types mixed together in a default order. Skin of color will sort skin of color images to the top so you can focus on those first. At VisualDx, we understand how important it is to view and share images that match your patient. The filter function can help you further narrow down the images. We've added checkboxes to hide genital and severe images, especially when you are with a patient. Filter based on skin pigmentation, image type, and body location. Consider experimenting with a combination of filters to further refine your results to match your patient's presentation. Some of our images have captions. Images that have a caption will show an icon in the corner. Float your cursor over an image to display its caption. Or easily turn on all the captions at the top of the page. Patients want to know they're not alone in their diagnosis. Use VisualDx to show them images that closely match their own condition. For instance, Dr. Nkosa Delova shared with us that she finds it helpful to show images of central centrifugal cicatrixial alopecia with her patients to help them understand the importance of changing their hair care practices and comply with treatment recommendations.
You know, sometimes patients, once they see that other people have the condition, they feel that they're not alone. They feel that someone else has the condition and the doctor knows the condition. So I show them the stages, and those who are not compliant with treatment, I actually tell them, you know, if you don't take your treatment, your condition is like this now. It's actually going to advance and move to that stage. So those pictures are just phenomenal. You can just see a sense of satisfaction and understanding from the patient.
VisualDx also provides handouts for common and important diagnoses. Click Patient Handout underneath the diagnosis title, or click Information for Patients on the left navigation menu. Choose to provide a handout for an infant neonate, child, or adult with a diagnosis. Select the language in which your patient would prefer the handout. The text is written so that patients will find it easy to read and understand. There's a quick overview, who's at risk, signs and symptoms, self-care guidelines, when to seek medical care, and treatments you may prescribe. You have the option to either print or email the patient handout. The email will come straight to your patient from VisualDx. You can choose to include an image that best matches your patient, or share the content without an image by unchecking the image checkbox. Let's walk through the features of the VisualDx homepage. Use the search bar to simply search for a diagnosis or start building a differential by entering a chief complaint, medication, or travel location. We've also created a quick start differential builder and separated it by specialty icons. If your patient has an eye complaint, click ophthalmology, then start a workup based on a common chief complaint. Create your personal account by clicking on the phone icon. Once you have created a personal account, you can download the VisualDX mobile app on your iOS or Android device, log in, and use VisualDX anywhere and everywhere. You will also be able to collect and claim CME credits. Review the CME you've earned by clicking on the check icon. We have compiled common public health and education links so they are easily accessible from the homepage. On the left side, we've linked important information for users. If you access VisualDX through your workplace, you may see customized links in this location. Click into the left menu and you can access support, tutorials, and send feedback. We use your feedback to continually make VisualDX better for you. On the top right are a couple important icons. This share icon is on every page. If you want to share your differential or a diagnosis with a colleague, this share icon will copy the link. The world icon lets you change your language and region. Changing the region will provide diagnoses endemic to that region when applicable. The megaphone icon lets you send us feedback. If you are logged into your personal account on the web, your email address is a link to another drop-down menu where you can access your account, CME, links to the Apple Store and Google Play, and sign out. Every search you perform in VisualDX has the potential to earn CME credits. Before we go any further, you must have a personal VisualDX account to accrue CME credits. Once you are logged into VisualDX on the web, click on the CME certification button to access CME Home. Or click on your username in the top right corner and click CME Home in the dropdown. Your potential CME credits will be displayed by month and year. Scroll to the bottom of the page and choose Complete All Potential Credits. Complete potential credits by specifying how you used VisualDX to address a clinical problem and how the activity resulted in change to your knowledge or care. Please note, per AMA CME guidelines, if you select No Impact on Knowledge or Care, the potential credit will be marked for deletion as it cannot be claimed for credit. Submit only those credits acquired in a clinical setting at the point of care. Select Claim All Completed Credits, Review Your Credits, then click to claim your completed credits. Tap View Certificate to view and print your CME certificates. Select your desired certificate, then view or print as needed. VisualDX has teamed up with MedIQ, a member of the Covaris family of companies, to offer these internet point-of-care CME credits aimed at increasing diagnostic accuracy at the point of care. Access VisualDX anytime, anywhere by creating your own personal mobile account. From a clinical computer, go to visualdx.com/visualdx. Click Create a Personal Account. Then create your own personal account by filling out the simple form. Download the VisualDX app to your Apple or Android smartphone or tablet. Then launch the app and sign in with the credentials you created, and you're ready to go.